So friends, in this chapter, we are going to see the questions related to average. So let's see the chapter. Let's begin with the questions.
Okay, here is a question that what is the average of squares of natural number from 1 to 41? So you have to find the square of natural number from 1 to 41. So what that mean? It simply mean you have to add number like this. This is the square of first, that is 1 square, second square, 3 square, and till what number? 41 square. Okay. And I told you the formula of average, that is sum of observation. This is sum of all the numbers. Okay. Upon total number of observations. So how many numbers are there? There are 41 number total, right? From 1 to 41 you have to go. So 41, this is count, right? Or the number of observation, you can simply say observation. Okay, so 1 to 41 you have to go. So if you go by traditional method, it will take lot of time. So what you have to do, you have a direct formula in order to solve this, to solve the above one, that is sum of all the natural number. The formula is n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. Same formula you have to apply. So the first n is the last number. What is the last number? 41. 41, 41 plus 1, that is 42. Into 2 into 41, that is 82 plus 1, that is 83, upon 6. So you can simply cut it like this because this comes in the same table. So 41 into 7 into 83. So your answers comes out to be 6601. And this is what? This is sum of all the observation. Now your average is the, how you calculate average? You calculate average by sum of observation upon number of observation. So here total number of observation is 41. So this is only you get the sum. So you can now average of square natural number. You can write like this. Okay. So what you get? Sum. Sum is 6601 upon number of observation. So number of observation is 41 total. So this, after you apply, you will come to know the answer, that is 161. So 161 is your average of square of natural number from 1 to 41. Okay, so this how you need to apply. For sum of all the natural number, you have to apply this. And your average formula remains the same, that is sum of observation upon number of observation. So the number of observation is 41. So you simply divided that and you find out the answer, that comes out to be 161.
So here they ask you find the cube, right? So I told you cube for n natural number is n plus 1 power square divided by what? 4. So n is 27. 27 plus 1, that is 28 square divided by 4. So we can solve this now. So this can be written as 27 into 28 into 28. Right? So I can simply cancel this and this comes out to be 7. So after solving the entire thing, what I get is 5292. This is the answer. This is how you need to solve the questions of average. And remember these three formulas that I told you. First is for n natural number, that is first addition of first and last number divided by 2, end of the story. For square, n plus 1, okay, n plus 1, 2n plus 1 upon 6, and for cube, n plus 1 power square divided by 4. Okay, this formulas you need to remember. So here is a question for us that what is the average of odd number from 1 to 40, right? So you know the first odd number is what? 1. The last is 39. You can simply find out 39 plus 1 divided by 2. That comes out to be 20. End of the story, right? So this much simple it is. First you need to understand the concept and everything become very simple. Average of first and even numbers from 1 to 81. You know that first is 2 and last even number is 80 from 1 to 81. So I told you the formula 80 plus 2, first plus last 1, 2. This comes out to be 82 by 2. That's comes out to be 41. So 41 is the answer. So here is a question that monthly income of P and Q is 5. Average monthly income is 5050. Average monthly income of Q and R is 6250. And the average monthly income of P and R is 5200. The average income or sorry, the monthly income of P, they ask you. So you know that monthly income of P plus Q, there are two members. So divide by 2 is 5050. If you multiply, this comes out to be the salary, the cumulative salary of P and Q, that is 10110. Okay, so 10,100 is the average the cumulative salary of P and Q. Similarly, Q plus R divided by 2 because there are 2 people and their average is 2650. Right, average we calculate in this way. Sum of all divided by the number of observations. So after you do, you multiply this. This comes out to be 12,500. And for the third one, that is P plus R divided by 2 equal to 5200. So P plus R comes out to be 10,0400. So if you add all these three, that is 10,0400 plus 10100. Plus 12500. Okay. This comes out to be 10100. This comes out to be 33,000. Okay. So if you add all these three, means P plus again P plus R R Q Q. So there is 2 times P, there is 2 times R, there is 2 times Q. So this value comes out to be 33,000 after you add all this number. This comes out to be 33. So I can take P, 2 common. So P plus Q plus R, this value comes out to be 33,000. Right? So I can divide this 33,000 from 2. This comes out to be P plus Q plus R. Its value comes out to be 16,500. Right? 16,500. Its value comes out to be. Now they ask me the salary of P. Right? So if I subtract Q plus R from PQR, I can get the value of P. So what is its value? 6250. So if I subtract 6250 from, not 6250, it's 12500 because this 2 goes in that side. So Q plus R value is 12500. So if I put the value of this 12500 here, I can get the value. So this goes in that side, so P value I can get, that is 16,500 minus 12,500. This comes out to be 4,000 rupees. 4,000 is your option number 2. This answer is 4,000 rupees. Okay, very simple. Just you need to put the data according to the questions and solve it. Thank you.